Welcome to Jung Tuition. I am Jung. Let's continue exploring isobaric wind in relation to harvesting energy from the nature. Today, I'm going to unveil a new renewable technology in harvesting energy from such isobaric winds near the surface. So, are you ready? Let's go and have fun. I'm sure you have seen dust devils, at least from many channels on YouTube. In particular, dust devils on Mars were recorded several times where the air pressure near the surface is just a few hectopascals compared with 1013 hectopascals on Earth. In general, dust devils are considered as a low pressure and warm core vortexes. But more importantly, the air density at the core is lower than rotating air currents. Therefore, one has to take centrifugal force into account that makes the relatively empty core sustainable. The reason why the dust moves around the core with increasing angular velocity as they move closer to the center is because of the conservation law of angular momentum, which stops them getting too close to the less dense core. Have you ever considered, or do you know anyone who had investigated on how dust devils are formed? I happened to read a summary of the dust devils from Arianna Picciani's PhD thesis on cyclotropical winds on Venus. I will discuss her work on Venus in the near future, but not this time. In short, it has been speculated that dust devils are generated by convection in the hot spot. But unfortunately, it would appear unclear whether the air pressure around the ground is constant or not. In line with my hypothesis, air current appear arising from advection and diffusion near the ground in the absence of horizontal air pressure gradient. In other words, the air pressure around the hot spot might be the same. This seems to be the case in many observed dust devil in a sunny and calm day when almost no wind can be detected. That's why I call it as isobaric winds, which are conceptually different from the winds at higher altitudes where horizontal pressure gradient is zero. Therefore, it could be argued that the formation of dust devil can be explained in terms of such an isobaric wind, because no apparent horizontal wind in one direction is required. Besides, as you might have noticed that the spot where the dust devil starts on the ground must be relatively hotter than its environment. As a result, relatively cold air current will move toward the hot spot from different directions, not just from one direction. Because air density is the highest on the ground, therefore, a dust devil always starts from the ground, unlike the tail of the tornado, which moves downwards. That's my simple explanation for dust devils. And that's why I used this video clip in my previous talk, if you were careful. To repeat, dust devil can show up even there is no apparent air pressure gradient force around the hot spot in the horizontal directions. I noticed someone wrote, "Who cares this?" Well, I'm sure many people are interested in this. Otherwise, human life would be boring apart from eating and sleeping, without exploring the meaning of our existence on this unique planet. Here is a revelation. As usual, when I have my coffee in the morning, it occurred to me that one could build an electricity generator based on the principle I proposed. Here is one of my designs of such an energy harnessed device. One can build a flat cylinder with huge diameter, but without the side wall, so that air currents, strong or weak, can move into the gap from any directions. A hole at the center is made to guide the air current to move upwards, while a turbine can be installed horizontally, not vertically, as you see in those windmills. To initiate this man-made dust devil, the upper side surface should be made by a good thermal insulator, while the central black hole can be heated by focused solar beams by using a number of proper reflectors. And then just wait. Simple and easy, isn't it? Naturally, you don't need to put any dust in the gap because you don't have to make the cyclotropic air current visible. Unlike the existing wind turbine technology, which don't work at all if the wind in one direction is weak or completely absent, one can still enjoy harnessing clean energy from the devils without any strong winds driven by pressure gradient force and without polluting the environment at all. Besides, naturally occurred terrestrial dust devils are transient events and most last for a few minutes, although rare occurrence of large dust devils with lifetime of 30 minutes or several hours have been reported. By keeping the temperature difference between the entering cold air currents and the hot spot at the center, it is likely one could work out and continuous artificial dust-free devils for hours under the sun. So, if you are institutional investors, would you like to consider investing in developing this new green technology? Or would you inform this good news to the Tsar or the General Secretary of the United Nations? Please let me know whether this informal talk make you smile or laugh. Thank you for watching. Thank you for donation. See you next time.